Down and dirty in it. 26.
That's amazing.
Oh,
it's incredible. It's really hard. I know. I'm sure.
The thing that Will and I talk about a lot is the journey. I mean, we started in this at a very young age, mm-hmm. you know, 22 years old.
It's crazy.
That's why the accountability part really hit for me, yeah. because I think yeah. you expect your partner to know, especially when it comes to sex.
Right.
It's like, well, if you love me, you should know.
Right.
Mm-mm.
Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah. If you love me,
you should be able to read,
you should
my,
read
mind.
My mind.
I got a question to ask. You know what? I'm not going to get in trouble, so I'm not even going to respond to that. But I have a question to ask y'all. All right. So, about 5 or 6 years ago, I can't remember, Donald Glover was on, he was on, what it was, The Breakfast Club, and he was talking about saying that he won a career like Will Smith, Big and White, mm-hmm. meaning a big career, you know, to be like Will Smith. So Will Smith is one of the biggest success as a black man, as an actor, you know, you have the
Top
Denzels,
five.
You know, he's one of those guys. Mm-hmm. So, very powerful man. So in this relationship, would y'all say that Jada is submissive?
No.
No.
Dad, you clearly
she can't be submissive.
Make sure I hit the like button. So she's not submissive.
No,
I don't think she can be.
I don't think so.
I think because she feels like she is, she's equivalent to Will in a sense. So mm-hmm. she does not have to be submissive, because a lot of females that feel like they have to be submissive, they understand that they're. Husband has a higher
standard,
not even standard. What's the word I'm looking for? Chance,
higher regard, higher.
No, like she feels like the man is the head.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. A lot of women that are submissive to their men, they understand that.
Okay, so you know, it's a lot of conversations where we have conditional submissiveness or conditional femininity, and a lot of things people say that if a man is powerful enough. Mm-hmm. The woman would take the road and just fall into their femininity.
That's a lie.
That's a goddamn lie.
Fucking, you can see right here, that's all that shit lie. Is fucking cap.
That's a goddamn mm-hmm. lie.
You cannot you cannot be conditionally feminine. You cannot be conditionally submissive.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of women, they will pretend to be. Just to get what they want from a man, or
yeah, that's exactly what she did.
Right. Mm-hmm. She probably was at first. She probably could have been submissive to him in the beginning, and then once she realized all the stuff that comes along with it, she was like, "Nah, I'm good. I'm gonna do what I want." She want some entanglements.
Some entanglements. Okay. So I want to read this real quick. This real quick. So every time I hear black women are not submissive, it translates to black women are not easy to manipulate in my head. You want to submit someone that ain't got shit going for them, like, be serious, please. If you're leading and doing what you're supposed to, you won't have to tell no one to submit. So all these women are over here agreeing. They're agreeing like a motherfucker. Mm-hmm. But then you go to someone that would have one of the most successful black men that we ever grew up watching. Mm-hmm. And you see this woman's constantly disrespecting the fuck out of this man.
That's what.
Then y'all want to talk about when someone is leading and doing everything the right way, then you can finally be submissive. It's bullshit. Mm-hmm. It's bullshit. Big it's time. Bullshit. Yeah. If you have a problem with attitude that you can't be fucking controlled, that's just who you are.
Yeah, that's
a fucked up person that will never submit.
That whole take me as I am. No, you. I see you as you are, and I don't want that. Like,
what you think?
That whole
what's up? What's your name?
No, I think that it's a lot of situations where a lot of females, they try and get these, they try to win these men over by basically being the perfect woman.
They call them chameleons.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So they try to be the perfect woman to the guy and make them have this fantasy that this is who they are. And once they get them, they trap them, and hey, they open up the real can of worms, and they say,
chameleon. They fade into the role. Then when they think that they locked in,
that's why a lot of people, they say, once we got married, everything changed.
Mm-hmm.
It shouldn't, right? But a lot of people say that. But to even piggyback off of what you're saying, as far as Will Smith. We hear all the time from your boy Kevin Samuels where we see that a lot of women, they feel like the men that they qualify for, or well, they think they qualify for, they aren't getting those type of men because we see they aren't submissive enough.
That's
because
true.
Because they like, oh no, well, I don't have to be like this. And it's like a lot of,
they feel like they're Cinderella and they're the one that, they're the one this ball is for. They're the one, they're the top tier. I'm this shit. You do what I say because this pussy is popping. I'm the best.
But then again, we have men that do not do what they are supposed to do. Right. I had a conversation with your mom. Okay. And basically, I was saying it's a lot of men in relationships that should not be in relationships.
Mm-hmm.
Because women are settling, right?
Mm-hmm.
Women do not hold men accountable as we should.
Okay.
We were watching a movie, and this is why we had the conversation. We were watching a movie, and the female in the movie found out that the man that she was messing with, that she had this fantasy about, and she thought like they were in a relationship. And you know, he said,
"What's that?
You never asked me. You assumed." Which a lot of us do, right?
Yeah.
She found out that he had a wife and kids at home in another country, right? She broke up with him, got mad. No, I don't want to be with you. Da-da-da. Cried. Da-da-da-da. But guess what the female decided to do afterwards?
Go back with him.
She went right back to him. And does that make sense?
No, it don't make sense, but that's what happens in real life.
That's what y'all females do.
That's what happened in real life.
But that's what I'm saying, that a lot of women are in these relationships with men that should not be in relationships. If you had seen this happen, right? Both sides should be like, fuck you. You cheated on me, we good. And you lied to me, I'm good.
Yeah.
But that's not what happened.
Nah.
A lot of women are comfortable with being either a side chick or a friend with benefits. That should never be okay, in my opinion.
Yeah, I agree.
But it is something that's like when you said the whole situation, I said a lot of women will go for it. When you said, if you tell a girl how you really feel, you say, hey, I'm not looking for nothing serious, we could just be friends, we could kick it, da da da. A lot of girls will go for it. Because they want this man so bad.
Yeah.
But that's not what the female wants. As a female, we have to start going for guys that we truly want, and not that same line that I'm not looking for nothing serious.
No, because
the guys should do the same shit too.
Because you're right. But the ones you truly want are the ones who tell you that, saying you're gonna stick it through with them, because y'all were not subtle. Y'all not gonna settle.
You don't need to be with a man who is telling you that he is not looking for anything serious if you are looking for something serious.
And yet,
y'all steadily
there with that person.
Exactly, and that's the problem.
If you in a rush, bye-bye. If you in a rush, bye-bye. So yes. If I'm not looking for nothing serious and you are, I'm not. That's just like why a lot of guys or women too are afraid for the whole marriage commitment thing, because one person ready to get married, then the other person may be ready, and then you pressuring one person, then you like, oh well, I'm ready. Then the other person like, oh, I ain't ready. So bye bye. If you can't see eye to eye, what we here for?
That's right.
What's supposed to happen. You should be. The problem with a lot of females, we don't know how to walk away from relationships because we feel like we committed so much into this person, and the ultimate goal is, let's say, marriage.
So why she don't walk away from the relationship then?
She won't.
The man, the one who causing all the problems.
Exactly.
She why? Won't because they are in public eye and they're
no. Fuck all that.
Her life would die.
There you go. Because he know saying. She know that he is the source of the relationship. She is the source. He is the source. He the one that's bringing all the money. He taught her the game. So if she goes, I bet you $100 million. I don't bet, but I'm saying I know for a fact that come on now, tighten up now, take it easy. I know for a fact that Jada is not going to tell Will in his eye, oh, we need a divorce. She don't have the balls to do that. Cause she can't.
It's not that she don't have the balls.
She don't.
Why would she?
Cause all she gonna do is strangle his nuts dry like a towel and but do that kind of stuff.
But no, why doesn't he leave? Why doesn't he leave?
Cause he don't have the balls to do it.
Exactly. That's why I said.
So it's on both sides.
Yeah,
they both. It's not that she don't.
It's definitely a toxic relationship.
It's not that she don't have the balls. Why would I leave when I have a woman over here who allows me to cheat?
And why would I leave? And this man allows me to talk shit.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
And that man is Will Smith.
Exactly.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Will Smith allows me to be the bitch that I want to be.
She got Will Smith on a leash,
so he would not
like a dog.
So he's not gonna leave. So he's not gonna be like, I'm gonna sign this stuff. No.
Me personally, hey,
there's a lot of women that would allow him to cheat on them.